Hey everyone, Bowls Premier League is back. Yes, we've got some live bowls to watch coming up next week from Tuesday, the 23rd of February, right through to the 26th of February. That's Friday, which will be finals day, and finals day is always exciting at the Bowls Premier League. Clive Adams here. I'm joined by Nick Hind, and we're going to take a look through all of the teams for Bowls Premier League 12. G'day, Nick.
Lovely to be here.
Yes, mate. Look, it's interesting, isn't it? I mean, 12 months ago, we had BPL 11. It was a great time. Everyone had a fantastic time, and we had an amazing final. And then COVID kicked in, and it's been 12 months, and we're back here again, and we're going to have another Bowls Premier League. It's exciting.
Very exciting. I mean, it's been a hard time for a lot of people, but now that we're back and we're playing again. It's fantastic to see these great sides and the great club at Moama being able to host for the BBL 12. I'm really excited.
Yes, the Moama Bowls Club. It is one of the premier locations on the Australian bowls scene, that's for sure. And they will put on a fantastic show. We're going to take you through all of the teams right now, and then we'll let you know exactly how you can watch. And there's some exciting news for our Australian audiences. So stick with us, and we'll run through all of the teams. Of course, Nick, you're going to be live at the event, so you must be looking forward to that. You're going to be hosting our ringside live coverage, so that's exciting times.
It's big shoes to fill, but I'm happy to be coming in off the bench for you, Clive, understanding your situation in Western Australia. But I'm excited for all our viewers to interact with you during the live stream during the day, and hope you find my commentaries as insightful as yours is, Clive.
Very nice, mate. Let's have a look at the teams, and we'll go through in alphabetical order, so we're not going to be biased here. All right. So the Adelaide Pioneers are the first team we're going to look at. Wayne Rudiger, Scott Thalborn, and Rebecca Van Ash, coached by Les Carter. And Nick, these guys were so unlucky to miss finals last year. They were in first place going into the final qualifying round. They lost in a tiebreaker, and they missed out in the finals completely. They ended up fifth. Just shows how close this event can be.
From first to fifth in just one game. And I mean, this is the nature of the BPL, isn't it? That it's fast and exciting, and every game matters, every bowl matters. So it's really vital that they're winning sets and winning the tie breaks. I think they can be very competitive once again, though.
Yeah, Scotty Thalborn, a former MVP of the league, of the tournament. So we'd expect big things from him. Wayne Rudiger, as solid as ever. And Bec Van Ash, just one of the best female players going around.
All right, and it's a well-rounded side. There's lots of capability there. I expect them to point the end again, but it's a very close competition.
All right, let's have a look at the Brisbane Pirates, because there are changes for the Brisbane Pirates. So we're used to seeing Alex Marshall in the lineup for the Pirates, but obviously with the COVID situation, Alex can't be part of the event. If you're watching, Alex, g'day, mate, and hope you're doing well over there in the UK. But Jeremy Henry steps into the big shoes to fill there, and he's joined by Kira Burke and Aaron Hewson. Michael Breen steps off the rink into the coach's shoes for the Pirates. And this is an interesting combination. Jeremy been there before. I think this is his third team that he's played for, actually, having played for the Perth Suns and the Illawarra Gorillas in the past, and he's well up to the big bowls of the BPL.
We've seen that he's a world-class bowler at any standard, and I mean, just this week he's won a state pairs title with another one of the players that we mentioned shortly around speed. It's a good side. There's a combinations that are going to be new there, and with Michael Breen being the coach that hadn't been there before, I think that will help him out. And he's got that experience, and he might be able to bring the players together for this big deal.
All right. And Kira Burke, of course, the youngest player in the competition. Such an amazing junior record for Kira Burke. And we've seen her with such poise under pressure. The BPL is a new pressure for her, so it's going to be really interesting to see how she handles the big occasion.
Bright lights, the big crowds. It's all going to be a bit different, but look, if anybody can handle it, I think she'll do well.
Yeah, all right. Let's have a look at the Melbourne Pulse. Another one, probably of our more established lineups in a sense. You know, Gary Kelly and Barry Lester, they've been at it for a little while together in this tournament. They're joined by Ellen Ryan, who has shown over the years in the teams that she's played for, she's been so good. Mark Casey is the coach, and I love the contrasting styles of this team. Gary Kelly, so aggressive, loves the big shot. And then you've got Barry Lester and Ellen Ryan, so great on the draw shots for this team. Nick?
It's very well rounded. And like you say, it's an excellent side. you know, it's a real superstar side. And as you look at it, even the coach has been, had so many games for Australia. I think they're looking very good, but it will all come down to how they perform on the day.
Yeah, look, it's I expect big things for this team. And Mark Casey is the experienced coach. I expect big things for the Pulse. Of course, we've got the crosstown rivals, the Melbourne Roys. And they were runner-up last year in a thrilling final, as we alluded to at the top. Matthew Flapper, Carla Krasanik, Aaron Wilson, Ian J.R. Ewing as the coach. If we're looking for a settled side, this is it.
Very much a settled side. And, I mean, they came within one or two great bowls from Murray Stevens of winning the title last year. So I think they've got the capability to do, to mix it again at the top end. And they're one of the interesting sides as well, because they do switch around that skipper position between Matty Flapper and Aaron Wilson. They do move it around a little bit. So it'll be interesting to see what their tactics are for this edition of the BPL.
Yeah, they're not shy. That's either. That's this team. There's certainly plenty of show from this team. Plenty of aggression and plenty of show. So we'll see what the Melbourne Roys can deliver. The Murray Steamers, the home team, the defending champions. Ryan Bester, Caitlin Inch and Michael Walker. Kevin Anderson's the coach. We'll get to him shortly. Caitlin Inch comes into this team. It was Joe Edwards last year and Lindsay Clark for one game when Joe went down with the injury. So certainly be on the lookout for the Ryan Bester drives, because you've got to look after the safety. But the hometown hero, Michael Walker, I can't wait to see him in action again.
Well, didn't he raise the roof last year? He had his brother there on the Bucks night, and then, of course, that big bowl to bury the jack, which ended up being the winning match of the tournament. It was fantastic to see. But you said something about Kevin Anderson there. Do you expect some fireworks from him, perhaps?
I think the interest in this team might be on the sidelines. Kevin Anderson, he could be getting up to anything in that coach's seat. I reckon if I was the opposition coach, I'd be on the lookout. I think Kevin will have a lot of fun with it. And that's what this event's about. It's about seeing players' personalities. It's about seeing what they bring to the table. And Kevin Anderson brings plenty. Caitlin Inch, of course, has been there before. She's played for the Blackjacks before, so she knows what to expect. I think, look, they're the defending champions. They could go all the way again.
And the home crowd, very hard to write them off.
And Michael Walker, one of the nice guys of the BPL as well. So, look, a side that has had some changes is the Perth Suns. And certainly I can relate being, I wouldn't say stuck here in WA, but we can't get over there, you know. And Lee Strainer is joined by Ray Pearce and Genevieve Delves. Of course, Cody Packer and Christina Christic unable to join the side this time round. But, wow, some replacements here. And Josh Thornton comes in as the coach. This team's capable of big things. Lee Strainer obviously has been there for the last two BPLs. Ray Pearce has been there before for the Sydney Lions. And Genevieve Delves, well, if you wanted a more informed player, where would you find one?
Well, you name it, she's won it. She just recently won a state pairs title. And Ray Pearce and Lee Schroeder, two of the best four bowlers that we've seen in the game. They both won major singles titles. They both won Australian singles titles. They could do anything in this tournament. They might be the dark horses.
They might well be. Perth have made the finals four times, and I think this might be a sneaky little fifth for them, but we'll see how they go. It's going to be interesting to see how they can combine, because they won't have played a lot together, that team. So the early rounds might tell us how the Suns are going to go.
Yeah, look, I look forward to seeing it. It's a very different side, but they have had success. They're historically been a very successful franchise, and there's no reason why they can't do it in the caliber of personnel that they've got this year.
All right, the Sydney Lions, one of the most successful teams ever. You know, they've done the three-peat in the past, won three BPLs in a row. Very, very difficult to do. Karen Murphy, AM, Aaron Sheriff and Ben Twist, coached by Steve Glasson, OAM. They were third last year, and this is probably the second of our really well-established teams in the tournament. They know their side in and out.
They're very well-credentialed, and the history of the Sydney Lions shows that they're successful. Yeah, they're a very successful franchise. They're very successful as a group of players and very well-credentialed on the green and off the green, their former national coach looking after things from the sidelines there.
Yeah, and Aaron Sheriff, of course, the most crowned MVP for the tournament across the history of the BPL tournament. So, and I think for me, the key, you touched on it with the Melbourne Roys, the flexibility here between Ben Twist and Aaron Sheriff, they do switch up that skipper's spot. Often one skipper's in the first set and then they switch it around for the second set. And with players of that quality and Karen Murphy adding the icing on the cake, it wouldn't be surprising to see the Lions right up there again.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They're very versatile. And you know, if somebody is just one bowl out and that's all you need to be at the BPL to be missing, you know, they can swap it around and get, you know, get their own Sheriff in skipping or change it up and get Benny Twist in skipping. There's plenty of options for them.
Our final side, the Tweed Heads Ospreys. Aaron Tees, Chloe Stewart and Corey Wedlock comes into the Ospreys lineup. Wayne Turley, OAM, is the coach. It was an interesting tournament for the Ospreys. Last time around, they went from defending champions to finishing eighth in a very, very close tournament. This is a side with X factor, isn't it? They're all young players and all capable of the big bowls and the big moments.
Well, you're exactly right. They're young, they're flash. They're nearly as flash as the colours on their bowls. They're very colourful bowls. But you're exactly right. I mean, Aaron Sees has come in great form as well. He won a state title with Jeremy. Corey Wedlock has won a state title as well this week. Chloe Stewart's been bowling fantastically. They could do anything. You know, they could finish first, they could finish last again. You never know. But I do like them. I think they've got lots of capability.
All right. So let's get to how you can watch the Bowls Premier League, the 12th edition of the Bowls Premier League. It starts on Tuesday, 11 a.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time. So you do the conversions as to where you are. There's three matches per day and then an evening session. So 11 a.m., 12:45 and 2:15 for the first day. They change a little bit throughout the week, so keep an eye on that. And you can catch the daytime action in the company of our man Nick here on Ringside Live on the Bowls Australia Facebook page. So make sure you like the Bowls Australia Facebook page. Make sure your notifications are on. And when they go live, you get a notification so you don't have to miss any of the action. But Nick, it's going to be a fantastic time. And one match plus live scores of all the other matches, live updates and so forth throughout.
Correct, yeah. We look forward to bringing you great games across every session on every day and keep you updated on all the scores across all the rinks, as well as the BPL Cup semi-finals and finals, which will be coming up towards the back end of the program too.
Yeah, BPL Cup, fantastic opportunity for those players to get over there and enjoy the experience. But then, of course, we get to the nighttime sessions, and nighttime sessions are a bit special at the BPL. The lights go on, the atmosphere goes up, the crowd really closes in. And from 5 p.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time right through to 10 o'clock Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time, you can catch all the action. Now, how can you catch it? Well, if you're in Australia, you can get it on Fox Sports, or there is an opportunity to get it on KO Freebie, a new initiative from KO, which is a free opportunity for Australian viewers to watch all of the BPL action. So all the details are just coming out regarding KO Freebie. So keep an eye on the Bowls Australia Facebook page in the coming days, and all of the information will be there as to how you can go about watching it for free in Australia. You don't have to miss any of the action. How exciting is that? For New Zealand viewers, you'll get all the action via Sky Sports. And for our international audience, the night sessions will be live on Facebook for you to watch. So that is how you can keep across it. We've never been so accessible to a Bowls Premier League event, and it's so exciting. Nick, you must be pinching yourself, mate. There's only a few days left before the start of the event. You must be looking forward to it.
It feels like a dream time, but I can't wait to get to Moama. It's very exciting, and I'm looking forward to being there and experiencing all the action in person and bringing it all to our viewers across Facebook and there. Each evening.
All right, there you have it. You have all of the information you need to enjoy the Bowls Premier League. I'll be watching it like you. I'll be sitting at home watching it. I wish I was there. But all the best, Nick. Have a fantastic week. And to everyone out there, please enjoy the Bowls Premier League. Live Bowls is back on telly. How exciting. Enjoy the action, and we'll catch you soon.